Yes, I'm now on 10G. Although that wasn't the original plan. When I started planning my recontract with my ISP ViewQuest earlier this year, I thought I would just get the 3 gigabit plan and do a minor upgrade to 2.5G for my home network. Keep things simple. But ViewQuest also decided to keep things simple and simplified their menu to only have 10G plans. So my hands were tied. I had no choice. I was forced to upgrade my home network to 10G too. And as always, the mission was to do it on a budget. To find the most cost-effective ISP option for 10G, I used a simple formula. Total cost over 24 months, the typical contract duration, then adding on the cost of a router. This way, I could compare bundled router plans with no router plans. Some ISPs also have cheaper plan options with routers that don't support 10G. You have to pay attention to that too. So here are the numbers. Singtel's plan was $69 a month, StarHub's was $69.95 a month, M1 was $63.90 a month. MyRepublic was $49.99 with a one-time fee of $50 to get a 10G router. UQuest was a bit more complicated. $30 a month for the first 10 months, then back to $45 a month for the remaining 14 months. There was also an option for a one-time fee of $99 to get a Huawei ONU stick, which would allow plugging the fiber cable straight into a router with an SFP Plus port. No need for a separate ONT. ViewQuest also had some really attractive pro router options. I was very tempted by the Ubiquiti Dream Machine SE, but in the end, I decided to go all in and DIY my own router. To build my own router, I reused an old PC I already had. All I needed was to add a PCI card with two SFP Plus ports, and I found one for just $48 on Shopee. On the software side, however, things were not as straightforward. I installed OPN Sense, an open source router firewall system, and quickly realized that I was in for some serious tinkering. I had to manually configure interfaces for WAN and LAN, set up firewall rules, figure out how to manage comms between my 10G and my 1G switches, and let's not even talk about how many attempts it took me to get WireGuard VPN up and running again. After a lot of trial and error, here's the final setup. SFP port 1 for WAN, port 2 for 10G LAN, and the motherboard Ethernet port for 1G LAN. Pro tip, I didn't commit to the recontract until I got everything up and working, just in case I wanted to give up and take one of the bundled router options. With the router up and running, the next step was upgrading key devices to 10G. The NAS was super easy. Synology has a drop-in module for this, and it took probably less than a minute to pop it in. My PC, on the other hand, was far more complex. ITX builds typically don't have spare PCI slots, but I managed to use an M.2 to PCIe adapter and connected it to the second M.2 slot on the motherboard. It was tight, but it worked. So for the final setup, I have this TP-Link 5-port switch for the 10G devices, my original UniFi switch for 1G devices, and Wi-Fi access points remained on the 1G switch. When the ViewQuest engineer came to set up the ONU, his speed test hit 8,500 megabits. Super exciting, right? But then I ran my own speed test, and it was 1,500 megabits. It was after many hours of troubleshooting and testing before I finally found the problem. Initially, I was using this coupler to make everything look nice on the back of my PC, but it had to go. So now I have this network cable dangling out of the PC. Not very sexy, but hey, everything works. Speed tests now average around 6,200 megabits, which is still far below the 8,500 I was aiming for. Although, internal LAN connections to the NAS do hit 8.3 gigabits, the likely bottleneck is the CPU on the OPN Sense box. CPU utilization hit about 90%, so it's probably just because it's an old CPU. So, is 10G worth it? Absolutely. It's insanely fast. I mean, I downloaded a 37GB Counter-Strike game in less than 3 minutes, and that's only maxing out at 2.1 gigabits to the Steam servers before the download even finished. But not being able to hit at least 8 gigabits on speed tests really bugs me. So I'll probably keep trying to tinker with this over the next few weeks. It's almost crazy to think that I'm complaining about only hitting 6,500 megabits when just last week I was still capped up at 950 megabits. There are other details to figure out too, like what's the backup plan. If this DIY router fails, I can't exactly reuse my old UniFi router with the new SFP stick. But that's tomorrow's problem. Today, maybe I'll go download that 300GB Call of Duty again. That's all for today. Thanks for watching, and I'll catch you in the next one.